When using PI ProcessBook displays, often users will want to have a single uniform view that they can use to understand multiple similar assets or processes. I have a PI ProcessBook display here monitoring vital information for my mixing tank 1. But I have other tanks in my plant that have similar process data points, points like flow rates and products. In PI ProcessBook, you can build a display that will change the data it's presenting based on which current asset or process you're interested in. Once configured in this way, you can flip through those elements and your display will update depending on what you have selected. These displays are called element relative displays and can save a lot of time by scaling a single display up to an unlimited amount of assets or processes, as well as ensuring that you're always analyzing or viewing all of these similar displays in a uniform way. Let's go to my Mixing Tank 1 display that I made in another video. If I was to make another Mixing Tank 2 and my two storage tank displays to copy this one, it might take a lot of time. But in this video, we'll be converting my Mixing Tank 1 display into an element relative display, so I can quickly switch through all the tanks in my plant. Because element relative displays require that all your elements have a uniform set of attributes, the first thing to do is inspect your asset framework for all those attributes. So let's view the AF browser, and we can see here my AF structure has a production area, two production lines, and then my four tanks underneath them. And viewing the AF properties, after rearranging these windows a little bit, we can cycle through our tanks and see our properties update. So for instance, we can see Mixing Tank 2 has all the same attributes as Storage Tank 2. And that's because we know that they're all built off the same template as shown by this little green T here. So we can close these now and start converting our values into element relative values. So to make any changes, we'll open up build mode. Double-clicking on the first value, we pull up the define value window. And what we'll do is pull this pull-down menu down and choose the element relative search option. Now eventually, I'll choose an attribute of my element, but first I need to choose an example element to base that attribute off of. So I can choose to search for that element by using a root, where I can select it in the AF browser and choose to search by sub-elements or not. And I can also search by name or any other filters here. What I'm going to do is have a wildcard for a name and then search for anything with a generic tank template. This is a convenient way to search because anything with my generic tank template is almost guaranteed to have the same attributes. Now searching, we'll select our four tanks and hit OK. Now we'll choose our attribute of this example element to add to the selected attributes field down here. So we'll select diameter for our first value, click the down arrow to send it to the selected attribute field, and then hit OK. And we can see here our configuration string takes the form e.diameter, which is short for element relatives diameter attribute. So we see that it didn't change when I hit OK. But if I view my element relative display properties, we can see that's because I have Mixing Tank 1 selected anyways. Clicking on Storage Tank 1 will change the diameter to a new value reflecting Storage Tank 1's diameter. So what we can do now is change the rest of the values in our display to accommodate the element relative feature. So next we'll do height. Remember, double click, pull down, element relative. And this time we already have Storage Tank 1 here in our element of interest. So we can simply select the height attribute and hit OK. And this time it's element relative's height. So we'll hit OK. Next we'll do product in the same way. And all of these are taking the element relative dot attribute form. So I'm going to manually type this in for the next couple to save some time. E.volume. This one will be my mixer. Here will be my flow rate in. This is my flow rate out. And the last two are my trend and my bar graph. These are going to be a similar process with this pull down and then element relative. Now my bar graph is mimicking my level, so we'll add that. Next we'll do the trend, so double clicking. Let's clear the current points in the plot and search for element relative attributes. Here I'll use the pressure and internal temperature. And because trends can accommodate multiple data sources, I'm going to use the pressure attribute and then also add the internal temperature attribute at the same time. So we'll hit OK, OK. Now flipping through, we can see all my values update based on the element I have selected. The last thing I'll do is change my title to reflect the current element I've selected, and I actually have some multi-state symbols here that also need to be changed. So we'll move our title out of the way, and we'll add a value. Here in the element relative search, the element name actually isn't here in the attribute field. I have to click this button, specially made to add the element's name to my selected attribute window. And we'll hit OK, and OK again. And I didn't outright delete this label because I wanted to use my format painter to change my new value quickly. And we'll move it into place, and then we can delete that. So now the title is changing when I select my element. And finally, we'll do our multi-state symbols. So much like the data definitions, we'll edit the multi-state and then change our field here. So this one is using the mixer value. I double-clicked, but you can use this button too. And this was also using my mixer value. And this was using level. So I can use e.level for that. So now flipping through my different mixing tanks, not only does my title change, but if I scroll back in time to a point where, for example, storage tank 2 had a value above 9, we can see that my multi-state symbol is working as well. So here I'll point out that we could have made all of this from scratch and didn't have to first go through an existing single tank display. And in this video, in a handful of minutes, we've changed all of our mixing tank 1 display values into element relative values. And in doing so, we scaled a simple process book display up to a potentially unlimited amount of elements, as long as they use a common set of process data as defined in our PI asset framework database. In a later video, we'll be covering even more ways that an AF structure can help us view and build new displays.